I wanted to know about your experience meeting Peter for the first time, because I was looking at your IMDb page, and at least the oldest thing that I was able to see was Dead Alive, which I have a major soft spot for.
Oh,
so
really?
Was
okay.
that where right. you two came together?
Yeah. Well, we came together before that. Like, I sent him a letter when I was a teenager, and, you know, I just had lots of drawings, and he... And we got talking, and he got me to do a whole lot of sketches for a film project that never got made with someone he was working with back then, which was a fantasy film. It was a big sort of crazy, ludicrous fantasy film. But then he just called me one day and said, "Hey, you know that film Brain Dead, which is Dead Alive, we got funding for that. Do you want to storyboard it?" And so I said yes, and then I was 18, and I kind of, that was my first job out of high school. So I left Whanganui, went down to Wellington, sort of bunked down with my sister who was at university and college to the Americans, and I started working storyboarding with Peter, and then worked with Richard Taylor doing a lot of the physical effects, spraying blood up the walls and chopping off, you know, making wax heads and.
All the important things.
All the fun stuff. That's how I started.
That's like a dream come true story. That's awesome.
Yeah, it was pretty crazy. I mean, look, you know, at the end of the day, it's like Pete had made, you know, Bad Taste and Meet the Feebles. And he just needed, you know, he wanted a storyboard for the first time, and he just needed someone who was young and cheap and hungry.
And you stuck with him, and look where you are right now. You're directing your first feature.
Yep.
Directing and the duties that come with it weren't completely foreign to you before, though, because of some of the other second unit experience you had. But even with that, going into this, what was the biggest surprise or biggest challenge being at the helm of your own feature?
The biggest surprise and challenge is just actually how much pressure there is on you. Like, just how much fear and doubt you kind of have to wrestle with each day. But, you know, you've got to muscle through it. You just got to sort of just... take a breath, just be objective, just try and look at the shots for what they are, try and see them through the eyes of someone who's sitting in a theater, and is it real, is it serving the story? And but that's a lot, you know, that's always the challenge, to keep that objectivity when you're actually worrying about the shooting day, you're running out of time, is the producer going to come down and say, "Christian, you're going to, you know, you wrap so, you know, is Pete going to look at what I shot that day at the end of the day and go, what were you thinking?" You know, it's like, you know, all of that.
Did you ever have that day? Because there's so much where I imagine you shoot it on set and it's like, look at this crazy thing that you can't see right now. But then later on, when it's all fully realized and finished, it's great.
Yeah, I mean, there's a little bit of that. I think, and that stuff actually wasn't the stuff I was worried about. Like, the technical visual effects stuff was actually... You know, I knew I was in good hands with my friends at Weta, and you know, I just that stuff I wasn't that worried about. But you know, yeah, being working with the actors to do the best job for them possible, allow them to do their best work, and also just try and, you know, keep innovative, keep the shots being exciting and serving the story. That's just the juggling, the creative juggling you have to do.
What kind of position are you in here directing your actors? Because an extensive production here, I'm sure everything has to be mapped out to quite the extent. Do you have any room to play with them on set a little bit and find things in the moment?
Yeah, no, absolutely you do. And you sort of have to. I mean, you know, you obviously got to shoot the script, but and I tried to storyboard as much as I could, but that was really just like really rough sketches. That was just like just so I know the kind of shots I need to get. But then you might be on the set and you suddenly find out that, I don't know, you just, that piece of equipment isn't actually going to work there, or the actor has an idea that's better than what you were planning. You know, if you storyboard too extensively, you sort of go in there with a very fixed mindset of, well, you're going to go there, then you're going to walk over there, then they're going to stop, and it's sort of, you've instantly sort of constrained them to do their best work. So you know, I use storyboards just as an idea of certain shots I need to get, but then you let the actors rehearse and you let them kind of, you know, you let them drive the scene and work with them until it's working, and then you might have to evolve that. So go on with the plan, but be prepared to change it.